Alright guys, I'm back here at the Disneyland Resort for my first Disneyland After Dark event since Marius Nights. I wasn't able to go to any of the other ones in between. This will be my first night tonight, and tonight is Star Wars night. It's the first night of Star Wars night, May 3rd. There's another one tomorrow, May 4th, and then there's going to be another final one on May 27th, which coincides with Star Wars Celebration weekend here in Anaheim as well. But tonight, I have literally no expectations. I'm going in completely blind. Just going to show you an overview of the event and what it's like to go to a Disneyland After Dark event, especially Star Wars night. I know this is an extremely popular one, so I'm excited to see what it's all about. I'm definitely excited to see the Star Wars fireworks show. So that's going to be a highlight. And that's literally right after it starts. The event starts at 9 p.m. and it actually goes, and the fireworks starts at 9:30. So, but we actually get early access to Disneyland at 6 p.m. with our tickets. So if you are going to Star Wars night, don't forget you can get in at 6 p.m. even though the event starts at 9. So take advantage of that for sure. So I'm headed there now to kind of get an early start, check in for the event, and see what this is all about.
So actually on my way in over here outside Star Wars Trading Post, they're actually doing a sand sculpture. What looks like maybe something for Obi-Wan, since there's a sign right next to it. Never seen them actually build something like this before. Very cool. You can see like an animal taking shape right there. Very awesome. All right, so if you're taking advantage of early entry for the event, you can actually check in, get your credentials and everything at the Starcade, at the former Starcade location, which is over in Tomorrowland at the exit of Space Mountain. And they've actually got a cool photo op in here as well too with Jabba the Hutt. This was a surprise. This was not mentioned in any of the literature, so excited for that. But yes, we're waiting in line right now. It's currently 4:47 to get our credentials for Star Wars night and our little lanyard and things like that. So definitely come over here, take advantage of the early entry so that you don't have to wait in the Esplanade and waste any time outside of the event after it starts. So here's a closer look at the Jabba the Hutt photo opportunity, and this is inside the former Starcade building where they do check-in. They also have the Sarlacc pit over here as well too. He doesn't move or anything, but it's a great photo op background, so definitely come over here. It closes at 9 p.m. on the nights of the events. And here's a look at the Sarlacc pit photo opportunity. You can actually walk the plank right over the edge. And again, this is still at the Starcade. All right, and over here at the base of Star Wars Launch Bay, they actually have the Boba Fett photo opportunity set up here for Book of Boba Fett. It's an awesome photo opportunity. I actually just did this one. We came over here first. I mean, the lines are still pretty long now and the event doesn't even officially start until 9. So definitely take advantage of the early entry. Some of these photo ops are available right away. Hyperspace Mountain isn't exclusive to Star Wars night, but it is open the whole event. So we're headed to ride it right now, and I haven't done it actually since it reopened. It opened on the 29th, but we're headed to go do it. First stop of the night after all the photo ops that we've done. I've already done way more photo ops than I've ever done at a Disney After Dark event, so I'm excited. We are inside the spaceport. Of course, it's got the little bit of theming for Star Wars. You can see the light speed special effects going on the top here. The ride itself hasn't changed. Of course, it's just some special effects inside and of course the soundtrack on the attraction, but it's a lot of fun and it's a great special edition temporarily here in Tomorrowland. And I can't wait to get on it because it's been so long since I've done it. And it's also available on not party nights, just regularly during the day. I don't know how long it's planning on staying, if it's just until the very last Star Wars night, which is May 27th. Or longer. I know a lot of people really enjoy it, but there's a lot of fans too of the original Space Mountain, so I'm excited to do it.
Woo!
All right, everyone, I'm over here at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge for Star Wars Night, and I'm getting my food here at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at Ronto Roasters. I ended up going with the glazed tip-yip legs, and they're over here, again, where you get your Ronto wrap, over here in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. There's new food items at almost every location inside Disneyland for Star Wars Night, but I wanted to go to Star Wars Land over here in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge and get one of the new items here because I felt like it'd be more special here. So I love tip-yip. Had it over at Docking Bay 7, so I wanted to try the glazed tip-yip wings, or legs, rather. So that's what I got, and I'm waiting for it to pop up now. I mobile ordered it before. That's my biggest tip to you guys. Place your mobile order before you even get into the park. I actually placed my mobile order for these wings, or these legs, before, like, way in the morning. So just keep an eye on it if you guys are coming to the event, and place your order way beforehand because it will run out. All right, so I got my food, and I, of course, had to pair it with a Tatooine sunset. But here we go. These are the glazed tip-yip legs. And they're pretty big, actually. They're pretty big. You get two of them. I'm not sure what the glaze is, but I'll tell you guys what it tastes like. And again, it's over at here at Ronto Roasters. I had to pair it, of course, with Tatooine sunset. Tatooine sunset is not exclusive to the party. You can get that here anytime you'd like, but it's just so good, I had to get one. But this is an exclusive item for Star Wars Night over here in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. This is my first item of the night. I've got another one coming too. And again, this is over here at Ronto Roasters. And place your mobile order. I can't stress that enough. I mobile ordered this and waited maybe 5 minutes, and the line is at least 45 minutes for this place. So definitely mobile order. All right, guys. So the verdict on the tip-yip glazed legs over at Ronto Roasters. They were pretty good. I would say 3 out of 5 for those. I'd recommend them to try them once. Definitely share it. And don't count on them being your meal because it's just two legs, but they're pretty big size legs. But overall, I thought they were pretty good. Something unique at Ronto Roasters that they don't normally have. So definitely try it out if you're coming to Star Wars Night. But there's so many food options, honestly. I wouldn't make that your only one. Okay, another exclusive item over here during Star Wars Night is at the milk stand, and it's gonna be this new Mon Cala swirl, and it's gonna be the regular blue milk with mango jellies inside, and then also a shimmering mango jelly on top as well. So we're gonna be trying this next. Again, that's over here at the milk stand in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. And I'm excited to try this one because I like the blue milk, not as much as the green milk. I know I'm one of those weirdos that likes the green milk. But this one seemed interesting. You know, I like the Toydaria swirl, the green milk and the chamoy and the tahini on top. But this is like a little more sour with some sour candies in it. So we'll see how this one tastes. All right, so here is another look at the Mon Cala swirl. And you could see the shimmering mango jelly there. It's kind of glittering in the light. I wanted to shine the light so you guys could see it. Because they said shimmering mango jelly, and I was like, what does that even mean? But you can see it glowing. And then the jelly's on the side too. I already took my first sip. It's pretty sour. But I'll do a reaction for you guys.
Wow.
Okay. The mango gel is really sour. Otherwise, it just tastes like regular blue milk, and then there's the gummies inside of it. So if you like blue milk, you're gonna like this. And then the additions kind of just make it a little bit more fun. So I'd give this one probably 4 out of 5, to be honest. I'd recommend this for sure. If you guys are coming to do it, might as well get it. It's exclusive to Star Wars Night, so definitely take advantage of it. But yeah, this is the Mon Cala swirl over here at the milk stand in Galaxy's Edge.
All right, so just outside of Galaxy's Edge is gonna be the Mythosaur photo opportunity right outside the Frontierland entrance of Galaxy's Edge. This one opened up a little late tonight, but I'm excited to do this one. This was on my list. I definitely still wanna do the Wampa one too in Fantasyland if I can. Not sure if I can make it over there, but I'll definitely try. But we're running up on the fireworks now, so that's gonna be next. So the vibes are really cool over here in Tomorrowland. They've got kind of like stars being projected on the buildings around the entrance to Hyperspace Mountain. And this gives you kind of an idea of just how light the crowds can be during these after dark events.
The Starcade right there is where we were to check in. The lines were insane earlier, but as you can see now, they're all light. And the Starcade does close at 9 o'clock. So if you see massive lines for people that have checked in and you've already checked in at the main entrance, but you just want to do like the Jabba the Hutt photo opportunity and the Sarlacc pit photo opportunity, just wait till closer to 9 o'clock and you can get in there with no problem. It's just you're waiting for all the people to check in who are already inside the park that didn't want to wait in the Esplanade. But now I'm headed to Main Street, try to get a spot for the fireworks. So we'll see how it goes. Honestly, if you guys are trying to come to an after hours event to ride rides, you're not going to really have a problem riding rides tonight, unless you're trying to go on Hyperspace Mountain. But almost everything else is a really short wait. So if rides is your deal and you just want like a Star Wars atmosphere, you've got it over here for Star Wars night. There are short lines everywhere, but everything else, photo opportunities, character meet and greets, which I haven't even done yet, are all really long. All right, so here is the super popular snacky sundae. It has a little snacky mac on it. It's got a frog. It's got a chicky nuggy. It has cookie dough ice cream, boba, I think, and matcha syrup. So this is the Grogu themed sundae from Gibson Girl. And I won't be eating any of it, but Rudio is about to dig into this. But I mean, come on, where else can you get? Oh, there's even like a Chex mix, like a spicy Chex mix in there too. So, I mean, come on. Chicky nuggies, gummy frogs, all in an ice cream. I mean, this is some interesting stuff right here, but I'm sure Grogu would approve. All right, so just to show you guys, this is 15 minutes before the fireworks show. And there's no one on Main Street. You can walk right on up and get a spot. Now the story's a little bit different on the castle area, but if you're okay with watching the projections from the castle this far away and on Main Street, you're good to go over here without much crowds. So you don't have to waste a lot of time camping out for a spot in front of the castle. All right, so we came over here to watch the parade and they actually put us in it.
Yeah,
so
they hand selected Danny because he had this awesome lightsaber. Danny's gonna be row two and we're walking down Main Street.
Yes.
I feel like Sharpay Evans getting ready for the spring musical, you guys.
So we really wanted to just come see because we heard that Mickey and Minnie were gonna be in their Star Wars costumes. That's how we came, but we're gonna be in it instead walking with them. So I'm down for it.
Dreams come true. Come true.
So we actually are walking behind the parade.
Stay on target, stay focused.
Let's go!
Whoa!
Let's hear it for Mickey and Minnie!
Yeah! If you guys are looking for a BBA in Galaxy's Edge, the BBA meet and greet is over here where all the like recycled droids are. You can see he's right there. Not too long of a line over here either for BBA, so probably 15 minutes. But honestly, such a cool photo op with him in that back area where all the droids are, and it's just around the corner from the droid depot if you guys
kind of by the restrooms if you guys know where that's located. But we are headed now over to Critter Country because top of my list was meeting the Ewoks tonight. So we're going to meet some Ewoks, and I'm definitely getting some photos with Ewoks. And probably going to give them a hug, because who doesn't want to hug an Ewok? All right, so in Critter Country, just outside the Briar Patch shop, is going to be the photo op with the Ewoks over here in Critter Country. And again, this is right across from Hungry Bear and over here across from the Briar Patch shop. This, for me, is going to be a highlight of the day, minus us walking in the parade with Mickey and Minnie. But look at those little Ewoks.
Oh, great.
Oh, my goodness. Oh my gosh, look at the Ewoks! This is actually like the perfect meet and greet for them. This looks like a little tree right here, so I'm not mad about it. This is really, really cool. And they're so small!
Okay, we're back?
Yup Nub! Yup Nub! So over here in Small World Mall, they actually have a meetup with the Tusken Raiders. And then right across the way, they've got to meet up with the Jawas. This is cool. So over here by It's a Small World, this is the stage where they do the lightsaber master. And it's actually lightsaber training. I just hadn't had a chance to come over here when it was actually going because there was just so many things going on. But again, right in front of It's a Small World is gonna be Lightsaber Master on the schedule, and that's gonna be the training here. So they invite everyone to take their lightsabers and join in with them, and you learn from Jedi Masters how to wield a lightsaber, do all the moves kind of stuff. Think a la Star Cruiser. And then of course, you gotta come over here and watch all the projections going on It's a Small World facade. They've got the light speed projections going on over here, asteroids flying by. Just a starry night right now on Small World Facade, but it does change throughout the evening. And then hidden back over here, you can kind of see the blue glow right back there at the Fantasyland Theater. You're gonna have your Wampa meet and greet where you're hanging upside down in the ice, trying to pull the lightsaber with the Force. They had that at the last Star Wars meetup. And then there's also the trash compactor back there, as well as C-3PO. So these are like the main areas over here in Fantasyland that are super, super popular. And basically all the attractions are running too. And like I mentioned, they've got no wait. As you saw, Small World is empty. And earlier today, Small World had a 45-minute wait. So honestly, if riding attractions is your thing during the nights here for these after dinner, after party nights, if riding attractions is your thing here for these after dark nights, you'll have zero wait doing that at these events.
We will meet again.
Over here in Tomorrowland, we actually have Ahsoka. We thought she was gonna be on Main Street, but she's actually here in Tomorrowland, and she's actually greeting guests from up above. I wasn't spending a lot of time in Tomorrowland other than earlier today, so I don't know that she was here meeting and greeting guests down below, but at least for right now, she's up above waving at everyone. And this is over here at Star Wars Launch Bay. Loving the vibes over here again in Tomorrowland. I know I showed them a little earlier, but it looks just so much cooler at nighttime. And again, guys, I can't say it enough. There is like no waits for any of the rides except for Rise of the Resistance and Hyperspace Mountain. Otherwise, everything else is a walk-in. So Star Tours, walk on. Buzz Lightyear, walk on. Astro Orbiter, walk on all night. Everything in Fantasyland was a walk on. I didn't ride a single ride tonight except for Hyperspace Mountain. And I don't regret it because, man, I had so much fun. All the meet and greets, the food, there just isn't enough time. But that's always the case for these Disneyland After Dark events. But honestly, this was by far one of my top two events. Oh, we just came in on another one of the costume parties, walking down Main Street. being led by Mickey and Minnie. Honestly, that was probably one of the highlights of the night, was being selected to be in that, walking directly behind Mickey and Minnie, and then getting our photo. But I'm calling it a night, guys. My feet are killing me, and I have work tomorrow, so I won't be editing this video tonight and putting it out like I'm sure a lot of people are gonna do. Mine's gonna be coming a little bit later because I have to work tomorrow, and then I can work on it after work tomorrow. So I'll have it up for you guys, hopefully shortly thereafter. And then I've got a podcast coming too, talking about some of the updates coming to Downtown Disney. And I also want to talk about this event because I thought it was so much fun and I want to share as much info as I can with you guys. But let's head on down Main Street. So we got the light speed effects going on over here on Main Street as you head on out. They've got spotlights going up in the sky here. Honestly, the vibes were pretty good throughout the event. I think the only complaint I had, if I can even come up with one, would be that they just weren't playing enough Star Wars music. I thought the DJ was really cool in Main Street, but I kind of just wish they were blasting like John Williams music all down Main Street. It just would have really set the vibes right as you're entering the event. But overall, I would say I give this event a 10 out of 10, hands down. It was so much fun. So many great experiences to just encounter throughout the whole night. They really filled this event. Food options literally at every single restaurant. Mobile ordering was a breeze if you were able to get in early enough. The only thing that was really difficult for guests would have been the merchandise. And I think they did run out of stuff pretty quickly because they were holding merch for the different nights. So the first night's allotment sold out pretty quick. But overall, a lot of fun. I hope you guys had a lot of fun joining me too and kind of walking through, getting an overview of this event tonight. And again, this was the first night of Star Wars night here at the Design Resort. We have one more night tomorrow on May 4th, which will probably already have happened by the time this video went up. And then we have a final night on May 27th, which coincides with Star Wars weekends, Star Wars celebration, happening at the Anaheim Convention Center. And rumor has it that event might be a little bit more special with some extras, because we will have some Star Wars celebrities in town for Star Wars celebration. So you never know. But if you haven't already, guys, hit this like button on this video, subscribe to the channel, some more stuff coming. And also leave a comment below letting me know if you plan on doing Star Wars night next year. Thanks again, guys, for watching, and we'll see you soon.